Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one true God.
Glory be to him, and may his grace and mercy be upon us forever. Amen.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, by whose glory the heaven and the earth are filled. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who has come and is to come in the name of the Lord. Glory be to him in the highest.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, Almighty. Holy art thou, Immortal. Crucified for us, have mercy on us.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, Almighty. Holy art thou, Immortal. Crucified for us, have mercy on us.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, Almighty. Holy art thou, Immortal. Crucified for us, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, be kind and have mercy. Lord, accept our office and our entreaties. Have mercy on us.
Glory be to thee, O God.
Glory be to thee, O Creator. Glory be to thee, O King. Christ, to thus petition us, thy servants, Baltimore.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts and sins, as we also have forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
Our Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, our Lord Jesus Christ. O Virgin Saint Mary, O Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at all times, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We believe in one true God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in the one Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the only begotten, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten not made, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and became man, and he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered, and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father, and he shall come again with
glory to judge the living and the dead,
whose kingdom shall have no end. And we believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets.
In one holy, catholic, and apostolic church,
we acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
O Heavenly Father, thank you for giving us this wonderful evening as we are about to enter into the compline prayer and the vigil that we are about to take. O Heavenly Father, be with each and every one of us who are, who will be, and who are not partaking in this humble vigil. As you have said, where one or two people come in my name, I am in the midst of them. The same way, Lord, when we start our prayer today, we fully believe that you are among us, especially among the trials, among the tribulations, among the sickness that is going around. O Heavenly Father, as you are the healer of all the infirmities, please help us to find a solution to the problem. Lord, because of this sickness, the churches are being closed. People can't travel. People can't come to the as a congregation. People are dying. People are crying out, Lord. Your whole creation is in weeping. Heavenly Father, as we all witnessed your resurrection a few days back, Father, let your resurrection give us hope. As the bronze serpent healed many of the infirmities of the Israelites, Heavenly Father, we are looking towards your face. We are looking towards you so that when we look at your face, we will be healed. The solution to all our problems, you will show it to us. As the church fathers believe that anyone, if you want to see the eternal salvation, take up the cross, just like you said, because it is through cross that we can achieve your love. We can inherit the blessing that is the kingdom of heaven. We once again submit all our families, all our children, all the sick, all the departed, people who are far, people who are near. Our Heavenly Father, we once again submit each and every one of the creation that you have created. Anyone that is going away from you, you will go behind that person to save him or her. We once again submit everything unto your feet. Shower us under your divine wings so that all the problems and trials can be overcome. We ask this vigil to be a great success and help each and every one of us in a humble prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one true God. Amen.
Amen.
I sing praises to your name, O God, praises to your name, O God, for your name is great and worthy to be praised. I sing praises to your name, O Lord, praises to your name, O Lord, for your name is great and worthy to be praised. I sing glory to your name, O God, glory to your name, O Lord, for your name is great and worthy to be praised. I sing glory to your name, O Lord, glory to your name, O Lord, for your name is great and worthy to be praised.
From the book of Isaiah chapter 2, Barakimur. The word that came from the Lord to Isaiah, the son of Amos, concerning Judah and Jerusalem. Now it shall come to pass in the last days, the mountain of the Lord and the house of God shall be visible on the tops of the mountains and exalted above the hills. All the Gentiles shall come to it. Many Gentiles shall travel and say, come and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will proclaim his way to us, and we shall walk in it. For the law of the Lord shall go forth from Zion, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the Gentiles and rebuke many people. They shall beat their swords into plows and spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O now, house of Jacob, come and let us walk in the light of the Lord. For he forsook his people, the house of Israel, for us from the beginning. The land is filled with nations like the land of foreigners, and many children of foreigners were born to them. The land is filled with silver and gold, and there is no end in their treasures. The land is also filled with horses, and there is no end to their chariots. The land is also filled with abominations to the, of their works, and they worship the works of their hands, which their fingers made. A man bows down, and each man humbles himself. But I will not forgive them. Enter now into the rocks and hide in the earth from the face of the Lord, for fear and the glory of his might, when he rises to smite the earth. For the eyes of the Lord are lofty, and man is humble. The haughtiness of the man shall be humbled, and the Lord alone shall be exalted in that day. For the day of the Lord of hosts shall come upon all who are insolent, arrogant, high and lifted up, and they shall be humbled. And upon every cedar tree of Lebanon, high and lifted up, and upon every oak of Ashen, and upon every mountain and lofty hill, and upon every high tower and fortified wall, and upon every ship of the sea, and upon every site of beautiful ships. Every man shall be humbled, and the haughtiness of man shall fall. The Lord alone shall be exalted in that day, but they shall hide all the things made by hands. They shall carry them into the caves and cracks of the rocks, and into the poles of the earth, from fear of the Lord's presence and glory of his might, when he arises to strike the earth. For in that day man will cast away his abominations of silver and gold, which they made to worship worthless things and bats, so as to enter into the holes of solid rocks and clefts of the rugged rocks, from the fear of the Lord and the glory of his might, when he arises to strike the earth. Amen.
Matthew chapter 15. Then the scribes and Pharisees who were from Jerusalem came to Jesus, saying, "Why do your disciples transgress the tradition of the elders? For they do not wash their hands when they eat bread." But he answered and said to them, "Why do you also transgress the commandment of God because of your tradition? For God commanded, saying, 'Honor your father and your mother,' and 'He who curses father or mother, let him be put to death.' But you say, 'Whoever says to his father or mother, whatever profit you might have received from me has been dedicated to the temple,' is released from the honoring his father or mother. Thus you have made the commandment of God of no effect by your tradition. Hypocrites, well did Isaiah prophesy about you, saying, 'These people draw near to me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me, and in vain they worship me, teaching as doctrines the commandments of men.' Then he called the multitude and said to them, 'Hear and understand. Not what goes into the mouth defiles a man, but what comes out of the mouth, this defiles a man.' Then his disciples came and said to him, 'Do you know that the Pharisees were offended when they heard this saying?' But he answered and said, 'Every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted will be uprooted. Let them alone. They are blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind leads the blind, both will fall into a ditch.' Then Peter answered and said to him, 'Explain this parable to us.' So Jesus said, 'Are you still without understanding? Do you not yet understand that whatever enters the mouth goes into the stomach and is eliminated? But those things which proceed out of the mouth come from the heart, and they defile a man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, false witness. These are the things which defile a man, but to eat with unwashed hands does not defile a man." Jesus went out from there and departed to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came from that region and cried out to him, saying, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed." But he answered her not a word, and his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she cries out after us." But he answered and said, "I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." Then she came and worshipped him, saying, "Lord, help me." But he answered and said, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs." And she said, "True, Lord, yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered and said to her, "O woman, great is your faith. let it be to you and your desire. And her daughter was healed from that hour. And Jesus departed from there, skirted the Sea of Galilee, and went up on the mountain and sat down there. Then great multitudes came to him, having with them those who were lame, blind, mute, maimed, and many others. And they laid them down at Jesus' feet, and he healed them. So the multitude marveled when they saw the mute speaking, the maimed made whole, the lame walking, and the blind seeing, and they glorified the God of Israel. Then Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I have compassion on the multitude because they have now continued with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I do not want to send them away hungry, lest they faint on the way. Then his disciples said to him, Where could you get enough bread in the wilderness to fill such a great multitude? Jesus said to them, How many loaves do you have? And they said, 7, and a few little fish. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the ground. And he took the 7 loaves and the fish and gave thanks, broke them, and gave them to his disciples, and the disciples gave to the multitude. So they all ate and were filled, and they took up 7 large baskets full of the fragments that were left. Now those who ate were 4,000, men besides women and children. And he sent away the multitude, got into the boat, and came to the region of Magdala.
Psalm 102. Hear my prayer, O Lord, let my cry come to you. Do not hide your face from me in the day of my distress. Incline your ear to me, answer me speedily in the day when I call. For my days pass away like smoke, and my bones burn like a furnace. My heart is striking and withered like grass. I am too wasted to eat my bread. Because of my loud groaning, my bones cling to my skin. I am like an owl of the wilderness, like a little owl of the waste places. I lie awake, I am like a lonely bird on the housetop. All day long my enemies taunt me. Those who deride me use my name for a curse. For I eat ashes like bread and mingle tears with my drink. Because of your indignation and anger, for you have lifted me up and thrown me aside. My days are like an evening shadow. I wither away like grass. But you, O Lord, are enthroned forever. Your name endures to all generations. You will rise up and have compassion on Zion. For it is the time to favor it. The appointed time has come. For your servants hold its stones dear and have pity on its dust. The nations will fear the name of the Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. For the Lord will build up Zion. He will appear in his glory. He will regard the prayer of the destitute and will not despise their prayer. Let this be recorded for a generation to come, so that a people yet unborn may praise the Lord, that he looked down from his holy height. From heaven the Lord looked at the earth, to hear the groans of the prisoners, to set free those who were doomed to die, so that the name of the Lord may be declared in Zion, and his praise in Jerusalem. When peoples gather together, the kingdoms to worship the Lord. He has broken my strength in mid-course, he has shortened my days. O my God, I say, do not take me away at the midpoint of my life. You whose years endure through all generations. Long ago you laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you endure. They will wear out like a garment. You change them like clothing, and they will pass away. But you are the same, and your years have no end. The children of your servants shall live secure. Their offspring shall be established in your presence. Barikimur.
Greetings to all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one true God. Amen. Today, as we are in the midst of a pandemic going through a lockdown, I would like to share some of my thoughts on the great virtue, that is patience. The word patience is used in the Old as well as the New Testament. It is also referred to as long-suffering. According to 1 Samuel, lack of patience can cause you to miss blessings. Being patient is a vital part of trusting God, as our life circumstances are not always what we would prefer. There are many well-known Bible verses that discuss the importance of patience and appreciation for the present moment, like the fruits of the Spirit such as love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 and 23. Patience is one of the most valuable virtues of life. The power of patience helps you to empower your life, leading to wisdom and success. Success breeds happiness, and happiness is the product of hard work and patience. Patience must be made as one of the pillars of life, as a good amount of patience is the highway to successful and peaceful life. If you show patience, you can gain new skills and improve your talents. Thus, you can direct yourselves towards the achievement of your goals and objectives. Patience helps you control over your impulsive decisions, while it aids you greatly to deal with stressful situations and emotional ups and downs effectively. Patience also helps you become tolerant, allowing you to keep empathy at others. The more you are patient, the more you are tolerant of others, which earns you respect from them. All that needs to be done is to stay motivated against all odds. At this point, the words of Napoleon Hill are worth mentioning. Patience, persistence, and perspiration make an unbeatable combination for success. The power of patience is one of the major components of success. If you develop patience, it brings rich rewards such as personal growth, increasing the ability to gain more insights and understanding. It builds a strong character, leading you to a peaceful life. Thus, we should continually remind ourselves this saying: patience is bitter, but its fruit is sweet. I would like to conclude with a Bible verse from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Ephesians. With all lowliness and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love. So, bearing with one another in love, let us all introspect ourselves and find ways to be patient and stay prayerfully during this lockdown and get over this pandemic. May God bless us all.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. Your rich in love and Your slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. And on that day when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul sings Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my
soul, I'll worship your holy name.
Almighty God, we know that everything is in your sovereign control. We ask that you keep this new coronavirus from continuing to spread. Give government officials the ability to safely handle people arriving from other countries. Help people decide to stay home instead of traveling or going out needlessly. Holy Spirit, remind people to wash their hands properly, and while it may be heartbreaking, comfort families as they decide to keep their distance from elderly or high-risk family members. Jesus, during your ministry on earth, you showed your power and caring by healing people of all ages and stations of life from physical, mental and spiritual ailments. Be present now to people who need your loving touch because of COVID-19. May they feel your power of healing through the care of doctors and nurses. Take away the fear, anxiety and feeling of isolation from people receiving treatment or under quarantine. Give them a sense of purpose in pursuing health and protection others from exposure to disease. Protect their families and friends and bring peace all who love them. O God, I like to remember all the parish members. We be in fellowship to God. We be in remembrance to God. We live a fruitful life as God needs us. We walk the path which God has certainly sentenced to us. We walk the right path which has lot of goodness and fulfillment of all our dreams in it. O God, I'd like to thank you, Father Ronnie Achan and Father Mial Achan, who took all these steps during even this quarantine time so that we could be in fellowship of this holy Kurbana during the Passion Week. O God, give us the mental wellness, give us a purpose to live during this quarantine time. Let our creative minds run at a good pace and give us information of things which we do not know. Give us eagerness and hobbies to things which we like. O God, help us walk your path. Help us give our physical wellness and our mental wellness so that we be useful to you in each and every matter. O God, your power is the greatest. I plead you again that you heal each and every person struggling from this coronavirus and help them lead a good life. In the name of the Father, Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
May the love of the Father, the grace of Jesus Christ and the fellowship of Holy Spirit be with all our supplications, our families, our relatives, all people who are affected due to corona disease, for their recovery, all people working in the medical field, forever and ever. Amen.